Channel. I am Rajati from VLearn today. So in a previous video, we already discussed about introduction to C programming. And these are the contents we are seen in a previous video. If you want to see, means you have to see the link in below. So I already posted C operators, and the third video is data types in C. And today so we are just discuss about variables. So variables in C programming. So in this, we have to know what is variable and how to declare variable and how to accessing a variable. So these are the things we are going to cover today section. Okay, and variables are memory location, which means storage area in a C programming language. The primary purpose of variables is to store data in memory for later use. Unlike constant, which do not change during the execution of program, variables may change during the execution of value, which means we can change the value instance. So if you are declaring int a 10, means in between of the program you can change the value of a equal to 5 or a equal to any value. Okay, so this is not unchangeable. So it's not unlike a constant. You can change your variable name or values in between. Okay, and if you are declaring a variable in C, that means you are asking the operating system to reserve a piece of memory with that variable. So if you are declaring an integer, mean it will allocate 2 byte. So the 2 byte is based on the OS. If we are using the 64 bit OS, means the int will allocate 4 byte. Okay, and so this is the example. Int a is equal to 20. So int is nothing but a data type, and a is a variable. So variable means it is used to define a variable. You can give any name. For example, you can give your own name. Okay, and equal to 20. So 20 is a value. You can change the value in between the program. Okay, so if int a is equal to 20, means the RAM, it allocate 20 value in a 2 byte allocation. Okay, so next we have to know what is global and local declaration. So first, global is nothing but access to within a block or function, in which global it access throughout the program. So let's see briefly with a comparison. So first, local variable are declares within a function. Instead, global variables are declared outside of any function. So it can be used only in function in which they are declared, and in a global variable can be accessed in all functions. So in local variable are destroyed when control leaves the function. In the sense, if you are declaring a variable in a local, means after the accessing or after the using, the memory allocation will be destroyed. Okay, when it comes to the global variable are destroyed when the program is terminated. So it will terminate only the program exit. Okay, and the local variable are used when the values are to be used within a function. Whereas global variable are used when values are to be shared among different function. So this is the example of global versus a local declaration. So in a global declaration is placed before the main function. In local variable is normal after the main function. So this is the example of global and local variable. So next we have to know what is the advantages of global variable, right? So in a global variable can access the global variable from all functions or module in a program. We already know. So if you are declaring in a global, means we can access any function or any modules, and only required to declare global variable single time outside the module. So if you want to declare a global, means you have to, it is enough to declare only once before the main function. It is enough, and it is ideally used for storing constants, as it helps you keep consistently. Global variable is useful when multiple when multiple functions are accessing the same data. So if you are declaring once means multi functions can access multi time. Okay. So as usual, it will have some disadvantages too, right? So let's see what are the disadvantages of using global variable. So too many variables are declared as a global, then they remain in memory till program execution is completed. This can cause out of memory issue, right? Because if you are declaring a variable in a global way means the lifetime of the variable is till the end of the program. Okay, so if the till end of the program the variable is still present means it will causes out of memory issue. Okay, it will take loss of memory, and data can be modified by any functions, and any statement written in the program can change the value of the global variable. So this may give unpredictable result in multitasking environment. So if global variable are discontinued due to the code refactoring, you will need to change all the module when they are called. Okay, so if you want to change any of a value means you have to do it in every modules. Okay, so this is the some demerits of global declaration. So next we have to discuss about local declaration. So advantages of local variable is the use of local variable offer a guarantee that the value of variables will remain intact while the task is running. So if several tasks change a variable that is running simultaneously, then the result may be unpredictable. But declaring it as global solves this issue as each task will create its own instance of the local variable. So you can give local variable the same name in different function because they are only recognized by the function they are declared in. Okay, and you can which means you can use same name in a different function because the lifetime of the variables only within the block or within the function. So we can use same name in a different function. Okay, this is the one advantage of the local variable. And local variable are deleted as soon as any function is over and release the memory space which it occupy. Yeah, it's we already know, right? So if you are declaring a variable as a local means the lifetime of the variable is only within a block. So after that block the variable will be destroyed, so automatically we get the memory space, right? So as usual, we have some disadvantages of using a local variable. The debugging process of local variable is quite tricky, right? And common data required to pass repeatedly as data sharing is not possible between modules. They have a very limited scope. Yeah, we already know the limited of the scope. The lifetime of the variable is a very, very short period. So next you have to know how to declare a variable, right? So this is the syntax, first data type, and we have to give the variable name. So if you want to give plenty of variables name, we have to separate it by comma. So with data type variable 1, comma variable 2, comma variable 3 up to variable n. Okay, and this is the corresponding example of each data types. For integer, int with height equal to 5. So you can declare as well as assigning values to, for example, int with declaration part int height equal to 5. So in this case we are both declaration and assignment is done. Okay, and same way character letter equal to single quotes you have to put a and float age comma area and end with semicolon and double day. Okay, and actual initialization is width equal to 10 and age equal to 26.5. so it's nothing but you can first you can declare a variable and after that you can assign a values or you can initialize the values. So assigning, initializing, both are the same meaning. Okay, so this is called variable assignment. We can call this also initialization. Okay, so syntax is nothing but data type variable name, variable name and equal to value. Okay, so example is nothing but int equal to 60, int age equal to 31 and end with a semicolon. And C program as usual header file, and after the main function we are declaring int age equal to 26 and directly print of using percentage d and print the age. Okay, so directly the output of the program is I am 26 years old. So this will be the output for the program. So next we have to know the rules for constructing the variable name, right? So the variable name is our own decision. Okay, for that we have to know the rules. So a variable name consists of capital letter A to Z and lowercase letter A to Z and digits 0 to 9 and the underscore character. So the first character must be a letter or underscore, and blank space cannot be used in the variable. For example, you want to give register name, means you can give register underscore name. You should not do register space name. It will show error. Okay. And special characters like hash, dollar are not allowed. And C keywords cannot be used as a variable name. For example, auto, static, extend, these are the keywords. We should not give int auto, float, double. So these way we are not doing in a variable name. Okay. And C keywords cannot be used as a variable name. Variable names are case sensitive, which means small a is not equal to capital A. So reason behind is in a C program, every letters have its own ASCII value. Okay, so for ASCII value of small a is different from ASCII value of capital A. Okay, so let's see the what is ASCII value in a later video. And values of variable can be numeric or alphabet. And variable type can be character, int, float, double or void. So any data type you can give. Okay, so these are the rules for constructing the variable name. Let's see some example. So as usual, header file, and after the main function, this is called variable declaration, int a comma b int c float f, and the actual declaration is nothing but a equal to 10, b equal to 20, c equal to a plus b, and we are just printing the value, and we have to print f value as well as the c value. Okay, so this is the example. In this example, we know what is variable declaration and what is the initialization. So we have to next discuss about C typecast. So typecasting in C is used to convert a variable from one data type to another data type. And after typecasting, compiler treat the variable as a new data type. So the syntax is nothing but data type and expression. So let's see. I will give the two examples. The one is with typecast and another one is without typecast. Okay. So see. And the left side program is as usual header file, and after the main function, and I'm using the declaration part, and a equal to 15 by 6, so it will it will give the fraction part, right? So in this case I'm using the integer, so it will print only, it will truncate the fraction part, it will only print the whole value, which is meaning of int. Okay, so the output is. So this is a normal program. If I use the typecast means, so see in the right side, a hash include, std word hash and main function, after that variable declaration, and then this is called typecast. A equal to, in a bracket, I'm just mentioning the data type float and 15 by 6. So after this line, the A will be considered as a float. Okay, so that's why they are telling after typecasting, compiler treats the variable as a new data type. So new data type is nothing but float. Okay, so now the output will be 2.50000. Is it clear? So now I think you know about what is typecasting. So I will explain, and syntax I will give, and I will explain with an example. Okay. So next, print simple sentence in a C program. This we already know, right? And you can use this programs.com. So this is an online compiler. If you want to run the program, means you can use this online compiler. You need not to download that any text editor like Turbo or Visual Studio C++. Not like that. You can use your online compiler. In my side, my suggestion, you can use programmers.com. So it will easier. Okay. So next, using a function. So as usual, same. We are going to printing some sentence. It is using function. So as usual header file inside the main function, I'm just call the function hello. So in a compiler, it search the function called hello, and inside the hello, we are using the printf statement. Welcome to my YouTube channel. We are learn today. Okay, and one more thing, if you want to print double quotes in a output screen, means you have to use slash double quote and slash double quote. You see the difference of a printf statement. Okay, and this will be the my output. If you want to get double quotes in the output screen, if you want to print, means you have to use slash double quotes, end with slash double quotes. Okay. This is a printing number entered by user. So if you want to get the in this video, we already seen how to declare a variable, how to initialize a variable, and how to accessing a variable. And if you want to declare a variable directly, means you can directly declare, for example, int num equal to 5. Okay, instead I want to get values from the user, which means you have to follow this format. So as usual, header file, and in after the main function, you have to use int num and printf enter an integer and a scanf, we have to get percentage d. So this is called format specifier. In a previous video, I think in the first video, I already seen about a list of format specifier. We can call this also format string or specifier. The both are the all the names are same. Specifier, format string, format specifier, all are same. Okay, so for integer we have to use percentage d. For character we have to use percentage d. Character array means you have to use percentage s. A float means you have to use percentage f, and double means you have to use percentage ld. Okay, and this is the corresponding output. The number entered by user is percentage d. So is nothing but after the double quotes, we have to give comma and we have to put the variable name. Okay. Okay, I hope you will understand what is variable and how to declare a variable, how to initialize a variable. Okay, and thank you for watching. So if you have any doubt, means please give your comment in a section. So thank you for watching.